I want to take you guys along for a week with me just to see like what we're doing in STEM, and also planning to get ready for the next rotation that starts this Thursday. I've been having so much fun in STEM, and I was struggling at first because you see so many different grade levels throughout the day that you kind of have to change your management style like at the drop of a hat, and that is really hard for me, which I am finding out. And I have first and kinder in the morning, and I have the older grades in the afternoon. So I feel like I'm putting almost putting on a performance for first and kinder just to keep them engaged. And then for second, third, fourth, fifth, I feel a little bit drained and like my fuse is a little bit shorter. So I'm going to have to figure out how I can fix that, because as you know, fourth and fifth graders like to chat. And when they chat over me, it just pushes my buttons just a little bit. So I need to figure out how to flip the switch on that quickly and manageably for me, and because they don't deserve that. They don't deserve a short fuse. They deserve the full fuse that everybody else has. But anyways, I left my room an absolute disaster on Friday. I was like, gotta go. Gotta go. And you know what? That's okay. That's okay to do that, because sometimes you have to do what's best for you. And luckily, my crazy self gets here 2 hours before kids get here. So I have plenty of time to do that. This week, I'm not recording the announcements. One of my amazing coworkers is recording the announcements. So I get the full 2-ish hours, which is awesome. So first thing I'm gonna do is clean up this room, and I will be back. Just filmed a reel on Instagram, but now I'm going to go over the next rotation's first and kindergarten slides, and I'm going to make a list on what things I need to prep in order to be ready for that. So that's what I'm doing here. Follow along. Thank you. One thing that I'm learning is that the students don't go as quickly as I imagined they would. And let me start by saying, I imagined they would go at a glacial pace, but they go even slower than that. It's shocking, I know. Weird for me to think that they would be like up and ready to go the first few weeks of school. That was my bad, but it's okay because I am narrowing down what I personally think they can get done. And then if they don't get it done, they don't get it done, and no sweat off my back. I do know that I have specific activities that I want them to finish. So those are priority. But other than that, we try to go through as much as we can. For kindergarten, I'll show you what we are planning for next rotation. That will be starting on Thursday this week. For kindergarten, we are talking about different types of weather. So we have our driving questions. What kinds of weather do we see around us? I have a picture, a definition, and a video for each type of weather and tools for weather. And then finally, this is probably going to bite me when we get to this because I know they can't read yet. However, I am banking on the fact that they might be able to match the sound with the first letter. Like wind, or like thunder. Probably not, and that's fine. I'm gonna have examples on the board, so hopefully they can do that with a partner. If not, what a great opportunity for me to walk around and assist them and get to know them even better. For first grade, we're doing something kind of fun. We're jumping into space. So our driving questions is, what is outer space? How do scientists learn about outer space? We're going to read a book together, talk about what they notice, what they think it is, and then I'm going to give an example of the solar system, and then they're gonna make bracelet solar systems. So they will copy exactly what I have here. They're gonna glue it onto a bracelet and get to wear that and take that home. Again, we might not get to that, which is not okay. I want to do the bracelets, that's my main goal. So if I have to take either the book out or these What and Wonders, I will, because the bracelets are my most important priority. So, those are the things I need to get done. We are learning in second grade next rotation is all about landforms. So we're gonna have our driving questions. What are landforms? What landforms do we have on Earth? And then we are going to, I wrote a song about landforms to Billie Eilish, Bad Guys. I went around over summer school and I asked the students, okay, tell me what song is really your jam right now. And a lot of them said Bad Guys by Billie Eilish. Gotcha. So I wrote a song about landforms to Billie Eilish, so that'll be fun. And then we're going to explore different types of landforms. So I have iPads. I've created QR codes for them to scan with the iPads, and it'll take them to that destination. I have virtual field trips. I have YouTube videos. I have Google Map and Google Earth. So those are ways that they can explore different landforms. And then that'll be it for that day. Again, small chunks, not a lot of time, small amounts of time. For third grade, we're talking about weather versus climate. So our one driving question is, how is weather different from climate? We'll talk about the difference. And then we're gonna play a game. So I'll have a vocab or like an example up here. And if they think it's weather, they're gonna walk to this side of the room. If they think it's climate, they're gonna walk to this side of the room to show what their answer is. It's an awesome way to get the kids up and moving and having fun while also discussing important information. And if we finish in time for that, we are going to play a look it on weather versus climate. So that's what I have done for third grade. I guess I'll show you my landform song. I'm not a singer. So be kind.
Landforms, they are natural features to the earth made of rock and dirt. They are made up of different shapes and sizes. Mountains, plains, cliffs, and plateaus, valleys, canyons, caves, volcanoes, peninsulas, and islands too. These are just a few. So we're doing research all about the Earth, all that it is made of on the planet we love. They all change, yes it is kind of strange, with the water and wind changes will begin to make landforms. Duh. Okay, so for fourth grade, it's very similar to second grade. We're talking about landforms, and our driving questions are, what do the patterns and locations of the Earth's geological features tell us about Earth's history, and how can maps help us identify geological features? Again, we're going to learn the landforms song. I expect this will take a little bit shorter of a time than with second grade, so we're kind of going to zoom past that. We might play a Blookit if we have time. Actually, that's probably the number one thing we're going to do, is play a Blookit. And Blookit is cool because you can set a timer for how much time you expect to be for the game to go. So that's nice. So I can set it for like 10 minutes, 5 minutes, however much time I feel like we have. And then I'm going to show a video on topological maps. And then the kids are going to create a topological map using rulers, Play-Doh, floss, and this paper. They're going to create a 3D model of a mountain, whatever a mountain looks like to them. And then they're going to take floss, and every centimeter, they're going to slice it and trace it onto their paper so that at the end, they have a topological map. So I think that's going to be a lot of fun. And then for fifth grade, we're talking about the different types of spheres on Earth. So our driving question is, what are the systems of the planet that enable life to survive? And we're gonna watch a quick video about what those might be, like an overview video. Before we get into a gallery walk, I wanna go right into a gallery walk because I want them to not have a lot of information to do this gallery walk and just try to see what they notice. Finally, we're going to go through all four spheres really quickly because as the week goes on, the rotations go on, we're going to dig deeper into each of the spheres. And then at the end, they're going to play four corners. So I'll show a picture. It's the same pictures as the gallery walk, and they will decide after talking about, okay, what is a hydrosphere, what is an atmosphere, they will see which one they think that this might belong to. And it's kind of tricky because some of them belong to both. So that'll be a lot of fun. So for example, this one is the hydrosphere and the geosphere because it has rocks and water. There's an animal one. This is the hydrosphere and the biosphere because it has animals. So it's kind of going to provoke some interesting discussions and conversations. So I think that's going to be a lot of fun. I'm really excited to like jump into content. I know a lot of like classroom teachers feel this way too. So I know you feel me on this, but I think that's gonna be a lot of fun. Let's find out. Okay, so as I mentioned before, I am part of the broadcasting club here at my school. And we just recently chose students to be part of our broadcasting club. So students filled out an application, they sent in a video of introducing themselves and telling us why they wanted to be part of the broadcasting club. And then the teachers of part of the broadcasting club chose which students would be admitted. It kind of is a hard process because not all the students can get in. We have about 20 spots to fill and 42 students applied. So it made it pretty tricky. However, you know what? These are great life lessons. That's what I'm telling myself. These are great life lessons. So what I need to do right now is I'm going to create a class dojo class just for the broadcasting students to jump in, and that way it makes it easier for me to communicate with them. Thank you.
excited for today because today is the first day of Broadcasting Club. So I'm really excited to see all the kiddos from last year and get started on the announcements for this year. That way they're just done and I don't have to worry about them because sometimes they can be time consuming if I'm doing them myself or if like another teacher is doing them. They're kind of time consuming, which is fine. They're really fun to do. But I'm really excited for the kids to take over that today. So I'm going to spend majority of my morning before school preparing for that. And then the kids come about an hour-ish before school. So we will like go over procedures and how to get iPads and log into all the stuff. And then they will go film next week's announcements, which is really exciting. And then during prep, I'm going to prep some of the kindergarten first grade stuff that I need for next rotation. I probably should do more than that. I'm going to try to do more than that because it starts on Thursday and today's Tuesday. So I need to be prepared for that. I also just need to clean up in general. So let's go. Club this morning was so much fun yet very chaotic. I feel like the first day of like any club or first day of anything is just so chaotic, and they'll get used to it though, and we will get used to it as well. It's my planning period right now, so I need to get things ready for Thursday, which is the start of the next rotation. The workroom that I usually go to get things ready has testers in there, so some students are finishing up some testing, so I can't go in there and disturb them, which is kind of a bummer, so that means I have to do it in the morning. But I'm gonna get what I can now here, so let's do that. So I keep everything for the next week in this bin. That way it's all in one place, so I know where to look. I also have stuff from last week in here that I need to find a place for. But yeah, let's go. prep period is almost over. I am going to spend the last 20-ish minutes preparing for the next classes for today to come in.